this episode of The F-Stop. We're your hosts for today's show. I am Lee Salazar.
And I'm Courtney Ellis.
For our first feature, we will be showcasing Mr. McLean's Drawing 1 class.
So, well, my first job I ever had was a lifeguard at a water park. And after a couple summers, they put me in charge of training all the new lifeguards. And so I really enjoyed it and was really good at it. And so that kind of inspired me to think about being a teacher. And then my whole life I was always pretty big into art because I loved to draw. And so I knew I wanted to do something art-wise in college. And so then the two kind of connected in college. And so that inspired me to be an art teacher. This is my 26th year. 25th, 26th, you lose track, somewhere in there. Enjoy the students when I get to see them be creative and put their own kind of personality into their artwork. You know, mostly I just teach drawing, but really my favorite format is painting. But I like to incorporate a lot of activities where you get some surprises and some serendipity in your art, so it's not always 100% in your control. You know, every once in a while I take a day off and that helps. I go on lots of walks at night, that helps. When I can get out of bed, I go jogging in the morning, and that helps a little bit. But yeah, it can get overwhelming, especially the last week of the 6 weeks when grades are due, like this week. But so you just try to plug away and get a little bit done every minute of the day. Sisters were in school and I stayed home all day with my mom, and one of my favorite activities I remember doing was just drawing. And we used to have a cabinet in my house is full of paper and crayons and pencils, and so anytime I was bored I just drew. And then when I got to school and I got bored, I would draw. And so by the end of my senior year in high school, I had like a whole notebook full of drawings of the back of people's heads, because whenever I finished my schoolwork I would just draw. And so it's just kind of built up from then, from my childhood.
Here at Friendship, we love to spread happiness. Here is a short film that shows how it feels to go to Friendship High School by our amazing AV1 students, Favory Bow, Jace Burke, John Aguayo, and Angel Garcia.
It's the eating.
Right there.
Who's that?
Another fine example of our fine arts department is the theater program, which recently performed a stunning rendition of Beauty and the Beast. Here is an inside look by another AV1 student, Caspian Lindemann. Let's take a look.
So there's a lot that goes into picking a fall musical. First and foremost, we start with the kids that we have. What show do they fit? And we just came to the conclusion that Beauty and the Beast was the best fit for our kids. And on top of that, it's a crowd pleaser. It's gonna bring in an audience. We love when we do a show that kids are allowed to come to, that they'll show up in their princess dresses. It's a family-friendly show, and it's just, we think it's a lot of fun. My favorite part of the production is getting to work with these incredibly talented kids. The hard work that they put in, they are up here from 4 to 6:30 most nights of the week.
For our set.
Mm-hmm. So this, what you're walking into right now is our shop. This is where we work on set pieces, get everything painted, decorated, this is what happens back here.
For me, the most exciting parts of the play are the big numbers. Your Be Our Guest, Gaston's, the mob song. When our entire cast is on the stage working together and they sound incredible, as a director, it's pretty awesome to see.
I'll be playing Mrs. Potts.
I'm Savannah Pruitt, and I'm going to be playing a silly girl.
And I'm Macy Higby, and I'm also a silly girl.
The thing about preparing for a production like this, that's at this scale, is that we're having to rehearse every single day. Starting this week, we'll start rehearsing Fridays. We go until 6:30 every day, so it's just a lot of preparation, a lot of repetition, and getting to know your castmates with this many people in your cast is kind of a challenge, but it's a lot of fun.
Before every show, the whole cast goes in one of the dance rooms and we circle up and we do a couple of warm-ups led by Miss Pearson usually, and we just, it's a way to get moving, get excited for the show, because when you're nervous and when you're excited, it's the same chemical. So if you learn to channel that nervousness into excitedness, so you're ready and happy for the show and you're just focused on the show rather than on your nerves, it makes it a lot easier.
Just
knowing that you're telling a story to people, that you're impacting people, making people's day better. I think that's just the best feeling in the world for me personally, and just hearing them screaming and clapping at the end of the show and knowing that they had a good time, that's really the best part of it.
Thanks, buddy. Hey, buddy.
Thanks. Okay.
Remember your training.
Uh-huh.
Ready.
Favorite part of the process is getting to work with these unbelievably talented. I have a pencil. My favorite part of the.
Hi, I'm Savannah. I'm a silly girl here at Friendship Theater's Beauty and the Beast.
I think this is my interview. Involved.
Get ready for a skin-crawling short film about something plaguing our society today: germs.
My biggest pet peeve is how dirty everything is. It's sad how dirty people can be. It's they don't even care about each other's well-being. You have to be careful out here, especially with these new viruses. You don't know what people can have.
Why would you do that? That's disgusting.
Come on, baby. Come on.
Up next, we have a delicious feature story about our culinary arts department from the AV1 students Courtney Ellis, Ethan Flores, and Phoebe Leopold.
In my practicum class, we are currently working on our beanie business. We have paired up with Mr. Sutton's class, and we help make all the pastries and desserts for the coffee cart that the life skills students take around campus and give to teachers. And so today specifically, we're doing cinnamon rolls. So a lot of the projects are more like catering events. We don't do a lot of like in class work, if that makes sense. And it's more of like I book catering events for a week or two out in advance, and every day we have a different catering event to do. So we can do cinnamon rolls, fruit tarts, baked ziti, and we did cauldron career night a couple weeks ago. We do a lot of caterings for the Casey Building. Anytime they have a conference, we do the desserts for them. Next week, we're making sopapilla cheesecake and fruit tarts. So yeah, that's kind of what a day-to-day class like looks like. And then when we're not doing that, we're working on their projects for FCCLA and that they're all going to be competing at here in a couple months.
So for example, my group has to come up with a sort of refrigeratable meal. Like, if you've ever heard of like HelloFresh or something, it's just the ingredients and like with a recipe.
We, in this level class, we are actually going to do a potluck where each student brings something from their home and they're going to make it here. And then I am going to be making two desserts from the culinary curriculum. And so we're just going to have a fun like Thanksgiving little feast. But in our advanced classes, they had a Thanksgiving project where they worked in a group and built a menu, and then we voted on the best menu. And so the menu that won, we are actually making it in class on Friday and Monday. Yeah, so it's for an organization called FCCLA, and there was like 100 different competitions that they could choose from. So all of them chose something different. One of my students is doing a cupcake challenge where on the spot, she'll have to make her cupcakes, frost her cupcakes, and make a display. So that will happen at competition. I have another group that are making like a meal prep plan type of project where we're gonna have to have like outside people come and try their food, but it's more like a HelloFresh type of project. So they're doing that. And then I have another two girls working on a like poster board project where they're gonna be talking about like their family tree and how family comes in all shapes and sizes. And we're relating that to culinary and how like culinary brings people together and makes like just family time like more important. We're working in our seafood unit. We had United Supermarkets come this past week, and they learned how to, I guess, like butcher a fish. They brought in whole raw fish, and they learned how to like fillet it and then skin the fish and then how to cook the fish. So they did this whole process in one day. And so from there, we are going to learn how to like work with other fish. And like that project I talked about earlier, where they're making like that HelloFresh box, they're having to learn how to cook and prep mahi-mahi. So that is why we brought United in, to teach them how to fillet that fish correctly. So yeah, that's kind of what we're working on. Then we'll have our Thanksgiving project, and then we'll have a couple catering events, and then it's Christmas break.
And now, for our last short film, we have a chilling story made by our very own Caspian Lindman. Let's roll that film.
Segment will be a stimulating discussion panel held by our wonderful host, Courtney Ellis, and her guests.
Welcome to the newest edition of the Tiger's Tea. My name is Courtney, and here are my guests for this episode.
I'm Ethan.
I'm Jace.
I'm Lee.
I'm Ruben.
Our topic for today is social media trends and how they affect our daily lives. So I've heard about this trend on TikTok called devious licks. What is that and how does that affect us as students?
Well, as far as I've heard, it's just mainly about students stealing things, mainly school supplies like soap dispensers, paper towel dispensers. I've seen even people steal like toilets and stuff, and like just a lot more stuff that has affected us.
I've also seen someone steal the principal's car and car door and bring it into the classroom. Like, oh yeah, I need this for a science project or something.
How do people get away with that?
I don't think they do.
But how does somebody not see you stealing that in the first place?
There have been, like here, people have been caught. Like, I used to go to the ISS room, and she left to go use the restroom, and she came back with three boys who were trying to steal the paper towel dispensers. But they got caught because they were being too loud. So I'm pretty sure most of them here get caught.
Yeah.
And if not, they just don't take it. They just make the restrooms unable to be used. So our restrooms end up getting shut down.
So that leads me to my next question. What was the impact of the schools shutting down the restrooms?
It was negative too, because you can be in band and you have to go to the south office because that restroom is open, and the one in like the history hallway is closed, and that's like the closest one to the band room, and they would get mad at you and say, hey, why you take so long? I have to go to the south office because this one is closed and they're just going to get mad at you and probably not let you do anything anymore.
Yeah, it makes that restroom time a lot longer and we're still expected to be back in those 5 minutes.
And it also takes away from our learning time.
So what about passing periods? Do you not have time to go to pass to the rest, like say you need to go in between your second and third period class, so would you have to go to the restroom and then go get a tardy pass because you had to go to one that's like nowhere near your classroom?
Well, it all depends, because they kind of alternate which restrooms are open, and you can like pre-check it before school, but there's no promise that restroom's gonna be open because they'll close them like 5 minutes after.
Yeah.
All of this just kind of sucks due to the fact that they're punishing all of us, even though there are people that are obviously posting this on TikTok or whatever. So yeah. All they need to do is just look up the trend or whatever and then figure out who the heck it is so they can actually get to the bottom of the punishing and we can all just have our bathrooms back.
But instead they're punishing all of us.
Exactly.
So are there any other trends that people have heard of that they would like to discuss?
It's not just trend, it's like social media in general, to where it will get kids in trouble for basically posting stuff that they shouldn't be posting.
Yeah. It's even to the point to where social media influences not just some of our actions that can get us in trouble, it also ends up dictating how we speak, how we act on a day-to-day, day basis, how we dress. Because there are people in this school, there are tons, for some reason, that decide, you know what, I'm gonna look like an early 2000s gangster and put my pants all saggy, which honestly, I do not understand why they do that. It just makes them look like they can't even wear their pants properly and that somebody just needs to grab them a belt or something.
Okay, so that leads to another topic. What about the dress code?
I know at one point some of the females were trying to change it simply because the males in our school were allowed to wear like muscle shirts or like really short shorts, like short. And the girls were kind of like, why can't we do that? Like, why is it different? And this also led to the bathrooms being closed because some of the girls were, I think, gluing papers to the walls. That it was just a simple quote, like, my body's my body. I should be able to do what I want with it. So.
Yeah. And back to, like, what Ruben said about social media, how it affects, like, our personality. It really does affect how we, like, how, like, just because of how we act on social media, it really can influence how we treat people in like in person. That's when like cyberbullying's been like a huge problem with people, because people are like, well, if I'm doing it on a screen, then there's nothing they can do about it.
Okay, that's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching, and tune in next time on The Tiger's Tea. Now back to you in the studio. Thank you for tuning in to the F-Stop. We hope you enjoyed the show and AV1's wonderful work. If you like our segment, make sure to follow us on Friendship TV and Facebook. See you next time on the F-Stop.